Channel 3. Are you ready for action? Well, hold on to your seats. It's Kaleidoscope Man.
Come on, Mandy. Time to get scrubbed up early.
Fully gutted.
Gutted? What's the matter?
Board meeting, 9 o'clock. No doubt cause to have the wind ripped from my sails again.
Tom, you're the best doctor they have.
That's mine.
Boxes? Loft?
I haven't forgotten. Just want to go through them first. Sort out what to keep and... let's take to the charity shop.
Can't Freddie help you?
No.
Your mother would turn in her grave if she thought you two had fallen out again.
and the UN gearing up for war, General Lucien remains defiant. And with only 3 hours left of this latest deadline, the world is holding its breath.
Go again.
We need some hope.
Yeah, buy a lottery ticket and give it lots of hope. I'll see what happens.
Come here.
The use anyway. You can't change anything. It's my lucky tie.
I thought you didn't believe in luck or hope. This might cheer you up.
My God. Finally.
I know. So why the sad face?
It's Tom. He's really struggling. I just pray this gets him back on track.
Stay close. Work through it.
Oh.
Right, that's enough, you lot. Good morning, children.
Good morning, Mrs. Dunn.
So God told Noah to build an ark in preparation for a catastrophic flood. He then got two of every animal and led them into the ark with enough food to survive. Once the ark set sail, it rained non-stop for 40 days and 40 nights. The land was flooded for 150 days and every living thing was washed away.
God killed the unicorns?
Oh, well, I think God just wanted to get rid of all the bad things, Sally, so that everyone would be okay. I guess the unicorns just missed the boat, I'm afraid. But I think the story of Noah's Ark is really about getting a second chance. Starting afresh.
So quickly.
Hello, Father Robert.
Hello, Tom. How are you both holding up?
Mandy's pregnant again.
Congratulations, that's wonderful. I'm sure your little angel's been watching over you. Tom, focus on your hopes, not your fears. You'll soon get used to it. It's great news.
I'm not here right now, but if you leave a message, I will call you straight back. Thanks.
Mandy, it's me. Let's meet later. Obviously, we got some serious planning and some serious celebrating to do.
Have got a lot bigger since the days of Hiroshima, so it's vital that we keep a level head.
Won't that be the very same?
You're late. Ties are nice, Tom.
From the start. You're okay?
No. They've arrived and you weren't here.
They talk.
They don't want it.
For God's sake.
Tom. Harriet, not now. Dr. Tom's very busy this morning.
It's all right. What's up, Harriet?
You told me you'd fix that door at the end of the corridor. It's not safe.
Harriet, it's fine. It doesn't have a lock because it's a fire door.
I know, but anyone can get in.
It's brand spanking new and can only be opened from the inside. Trust me, you're perfectly safe.
Come on. You would say that. You're a man.
Freeze!
Oh.
Jesus Christ, Floyd, do you have to do that?
Hey, Dr. T. Hey, on the news today, they said there's going to be another war.
I'm sure there won't be.
But I want to go to war, Dr. T. I want to call the military. You know, be first in. I'm a trained assassin, Dr. T.
Floyd, remember, keep your head. Keep calm, right?
Keep my head while blowing others away. Yes. Die, you terrorist pig.
Jesus, he's hyper this morning.
they all are. There's certainly only one Floyd.
At this turning, we play in the ball pit, then we down a slide, crawl through.
Oh, for God's sake.
Chilling image you're doing there, son.
I think they wanted me to see it.
Who?
The angels. I told you I'm clean.
Sam, you get to get better, but if you keep taking this stuff...
What are you, my dad?
No, I'm your doctor. And I want to help you.
You can't help me. Nobody can.
Do you believe in angels, Sam?
I think the threat of war is getting everyone worked up.
It's just another loudmouth terrorist state that'll end up getting their ass kicked. There won't be another war.
Fine, but can you just make sure you win this war? Please?
Miller, wait. I still don't understand why you're shutting us down. We've done everything. New fire doors, new bathrooms. Hell, we've even fixed the roof.
Yes, without consulting me or the board.
It was the right decision. Now we have a facility you and the council can be proud of.
Oh, really? Oh, well, I'm glad you were here to make such grand decisions. Who needs the board?
I didn't mean it like that. No one would just make a decision.
Oh.
Yeah, that's it. Jerry, wait. We improve people's lives here. The support, the community. Don't shut us down. I'll change things, find ways to save more money.
Look, I'm sorry, Tom. Everything has consequences, and these are tough times.
The transitional phase will need to start immediately, though.
Transitional phase?
The Grange will be their new home from now on.
What about my staff?
You'll all be offered a good redundancy package.
The patients?
You can't save everyone, son.
Thank you. My wife saw it, my friend saw it, and now people are discussing it all over social media. But what exactly have they seen? Politicians, bus drivers, doctors, and even some celebrities have seen what one African diplomat is calling the vision of the apocalyptic. Well, today I'm here in central London talking to
people have been having visions.
What their experiences were. Tell me, what did you see?
Well, I was just walking across Westminster Bridge when suddenly, boom, fire and destruction, and I could feel the heat of this thing coming towards me.
It wasn't
and
a dream.
And then my sister, who lives in Australia, she texted me.
Look, it wasn't a dream.
Too, but I've just spoken to some people who didn't see it.
I wonder what it might have been, because personally, I didn't see anything either.
Maybe some were chosen over others, I don't know.
Visions?
It was horrendous.
I thought I imagined them.
We all did.
Well, there was this fireball. It loomed over the city. And then it erupted into flames.
A mushroom cloud, clear as daylight. Smoke, fire everywhere. I tell you, something bad is coming. Really bad. I can feel it.
This is ridiculous. How can we all have the same? No way. Stupid nonsense. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come on, hurry!
What's that?
what you did.
Days. How did you escape?
I don't remember. We just woke up on that cliff over there.
This isn't home, is it?
I was an assassin, wasn't I?
No! You shot me and hurry up!
We shared the same experiences.
Yes, of course. The ambassador has spoken to MI5 and will be reporting to the Prime Minister shortly. Goodbye. How did you get in?
Floyd, what are you doing?
My job!
Floyd, don't get angry. Keep your head calm. Stay calm.
Where am I?
I don't know. But this is all wrong.
Sam! You've killed Sam! What have I done? I'm sorry, Tom! I'm sorry!
Listen, your ambassador is in so much trouble. You hear me? You won't take my 5 years about this. I'm a trained assassin, yeah? I'm a trained assassin!
Did you?
Of course not. I haven't always been ill, you know. I haven't. I wanted to travel the world once, do something important, like work for the UN or the Red Cross or...
How'd you feel now?
I feel clear.
You look different.
That's where we're gonna find him. Come on.
Yeah, let's go. We're going on an adventure. Come on.
Who are you?
Keep moving, okay? Come on!
Guys, do any of you remember the cinema complex?
We all do.
I don't believe it.
We're never alone, you know. There's always someone looking out for us.
It's wonderful.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's her. Get her out before she causes another scene.
Excuse me, miss. Can I have a word with you, please?
Come on.
gas has turned everyone in the city. Millions are now undead.
Tom, but my addiction's completely gone.
They fixed you and Floyd.
Yeah.
What kind of aliens are these?
I'm not climbing up there.
Don't you want to get home?
Home? I don't have a home!
You're right, Harriet.
He has to pay for what he did! I wanted revenge. All my life. I've hated every man that I've ever known. Because of him. Father. Billy McCoy.
It's all right. You can trust me. You know, be a good girl and unlock the chain. It's important business.
Harriet, wait for me. Wait for me, Harriet. Wait for me.
I should have listened.
So, Tom, we've all faced our demons. What about you?
I'm sure Tom's perfect. No skeletons in your closet, eh?
Sorry, guys. You might have all seen the light, but I just want to get out of here.
You are joking!
Look, have faith. I will get us home. Somehow.
We do have faith in you, Tom. But what aren't you telling us?
Look, I give up with you lot.
Listen, Tom. Tom, something amazing has happened to me. Now I'm free.
Here, here.
That's great, guys. Really poetic. But Floyd, you're a schizophrenic. Harriet, you've got a narcissistic personality disorder. Samantha, you're a manic depressive. Look, now these are conditions that can be calmed or treated over time, but I'm sorry they don't just disappear overnight. Are you coming or not?
I'm not sure Tom gets it yet.
Thank you.
guns.
Thank you.
Sorry, Harriet.
I forgive you.
Just point and shoot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Fine.
From now on, we stay together. It must be a control center.
Yeah? And then what?
Home.
the spaceship. A small ship put us here.
In a dream, all that.
We ordered. But it's true. We've been fixed.
Fixed? We've been here less than 20 minutes.
20 minutes? It feels like days.
I don't think we were brought here just to clear the skeletons from our closets. Why would they make us look back at our pasts? No, there was a reason.
From the heart of New York City. Well, what a day. U.S. and U.N. troops have engaged General Lucien's forces, and now Russia and China are threatening reprisals. And to add to that, this mysterious thing has appeared in the sky. Some are calling it a visual propaganda trick, others a bad omen. Well, we should find out soon enough. NASA has just tweeted that the ISS will have a visual in the next few minutes. Maybe they can enlighten us on what the hell is going on up there.
Station, this is Mission Control Houston. Commander Pilburn, you should have a clear visual status any minute now.
There's no line of sight yet.
You really should be able to see it now.
Hold your horses.
What are we looking for?
I guess that's what we're just about to find out.
What is that?
Object coming into view now.
Volume of traffic on the freeways has brought the city to a near standstill. Police are again warning people to stay in their homes. So to pick up, stay in your homes, folks.
Manhattan has been
destroyed.
Where is it? We're under attack.
The Chinese ambassador has just tweeted that China is on full military alert. Iran, North Korea, and Russia are yet to respond.
They're invading, repeat, they are invading.
Roger that, station. Standing by.
War, destruction, ruin and decay. The worst is death.
They've seen us.
And death will have its day.
Are they not following the Pacific Rim fault line?
What?
The San Andreas Fault.
This can't be happening.
Thank you.
phone signal.
Explosions in Tehran and central Israel, with politicians on either side threatening reprisals.
Please, somebody answer.
Hello?
Freddy. It's me.
Great timing as ever, Tom.
You're right.
Yeah, apart from fending off an alien invasion, you must be over the moon.
Push it.
They're taking us.
The attacks on New York were barbaric acts of terrorism.
Wait a second.
A nuclear device was driven into the heart of the city.
New York! What's your city? We will wipe the United States off the face of the planet!
General Lucien announced that in response to the attack on his country, a nuclear strike has been ordered against the United States.
Why didn't I say it before? Freddy, let them take you.
What?
I know I've made some stupid mistakes. I know that. But you've got to listen to me now. Please, let them take you.
But they're abducting everyone. Surely we have to hide.
US Patriot missiles were deployed, but were unable to stop the rockets.
They're not abducting us, Freddy.
Therefore, a strike is imminent.
They're saving us.
What?
From who, Tom? Who are they saving us from?
General Lucian went on to say that his country had no choice but to completely destroy North America.
Ourselves. You've got to trust me, Freddy. They're here to help.
Sure. They'll never save everybody. Most people will be hiding by now.
I know.
It's really nice to hear from you.
Hey, Mandy's pregnant.
That's really great news, Tom. Is she with you?
I don't know where she is.
Tom? Don't be afraid. It's gonna be all right.
People of Earth, attention. People of Earth, attention. My name is Thomas Dunn. I'm a doctor from London. I was one of the first to be taken. I'm not a leader or a ruler or anything like that. I'm just a normal guy. But I know why the visitors are here. From up here, we can see what's happened. Terrorists. I've exploded nuclear bombs along the fault lines that run up through Mexico, America, and Canada. This has set off a huge global response. Everyone's bombing everyone else, blaming everyone else. And it's set off a massive chain reaction. half of America is already gone. And it's spreading. We don't have long. I only speak English, so please translate. These beings, they're here to help us. If you want to survive, you have to come out of your hiding places and let them take you. I'm afraid it's the end of the world. They're our only hope.
Half of America has been destroyed. Aliens have appeared in our skies. I thought I should read you some text. But no. You deserve better. We have lost our way. Power and greed have ruined us. The boundaries that we've created have made us prisoners in our own little worlds. Even the color of our skin has made us enemies. But don't despair. We have been given a second chance. A new beginning. The misery we feel now is but the passing of the old times. But this day, our day of reckoning, it will define us. It's time to end our conflicts and fight for our futures. Fight for our happiness and prosperity. Fight for our love and dignity. Remember who you were, and then step forward into the new world. He will protect you now. He will protect all of us.
Beautiful the city was at this time of day.
Andy, please.
You are outside, aren't you?
Andy, look up at the moon.
You're up there?
Yes.
I can't even get a signal in the flat.
We're all up on the ship.
And I'm left behind.
I love you so much.
We gave it our all, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. I tried, you know?
You were the best.
Andy, please. You've got to let them take you. It's your only chance.
It's all right, darling. I'm not alone anymore. I'm with Rebecca. I'll never be alone. I just wanted to say goodbye to her. Tom, I don't think the ships are coming.
Hope, right?
Hope is all we have left. What can you say on a night like this? When everything has fallen down, an ocean of dreams is pushed too far. And now we're all alone. We had it all. Please try and not despair. There is a second chance. Now is your time, you will transcend. So come and step right up. Suddenly, you'll understand.